Two neutron stars caught in a death spiral. This massive kilonova explosion not only sheds light on the creation of heavy elements such as gold and platinum, it also provides scientists with a unique insight into one of the most mysterious objects in the universe.
Trying to imagine what a neutron star is really like really challenges our imagination. It also challenges our theoretical physics. We have to go to our computer models, our mathematics, to have some estimate of what this might be like.
Now, scientists don't have to rely on their imaginations. They can use hard data from the kilonova to work out what makes neutron stars tick.
There's so much information we got from observing that one single event, that one colliding neutron star pair. Now, for the first time, we have an accurate estimate of the mass of the neutron star and the diameter. We can finally begin to piece together how neutron stars really work.
They calculate the diameter is just 12.4 miles, 1 mile less than the length of Manhattan.
Nailing down any physical characteristic is really important, and if there's going to be one, the radius is a big one, because from there, if you know the mass, you can get the density. And if you know the overall density, you can start to figure out what the layering inside of a neutron star is like.
For physicists, the interior of a neutron star is one of the most intriguing places in the universe.
You have to realize that the conditions inside a neutron star are very, very different than the conditions that exist here on Earth. We're talking about material that's so dense that even the nuclei of atoms can't hold together.
With a neutron star, you're taking something that weighs more than the sun and compressing it down to be smaller than a city.
It's so dense that if you tried to put it on the ground, it would fall right through the Earth.
High density means high gravity. Gravity 200 billion times greater than on Earth.
Imagine climbing up on a table on the surface of a neutron star and jumping off.
You're gonna just get flattened instantly and just spread out on that surface. So don't even think about trying to do push-ups.
Added to the intense gravity are hugely powerful magnetic fields, awesome X-ray radiation, electric fields 30 million times more powerful than lightning bolts, and blizzards of high energy particles. For a space traveler, this is not a good neighborhood.
If you were to find yourself in the vicinity of a neutron star, it's going to be bad news. First, you would be torn apart by the incredibly strong magnetic fields. Then the X-ray radiation would blast you to a crisp. And as it pulled you closer, its intense gravity would stretch out your atoms and molecules into a long, thin stream. You would build your speed faster and faster, and you'd finally impact the surface, splatter across it, and that process would release as much energy as a nuclear bomb. If I had the choice between falling into a neutron star versus a black hole, I think I'd pick the black hole, because I don't really feel like being torn apart by a magnetic field and blasted with X-rays.
On a cosmic scale, neutron stars may be pint-sized, but they sure pack a serious punch. The secret to all this pent-up power is what's going on below the surface. Armed with the new kilonova data, we can now take a virtual journey into the heart of a neutron star. First, we must pass through its atmosphere.
Now, it's not like the Earth's atmosphere, which goes up like 100 miles. On a neutron star, the atmosphere is about this deep, and it's extremely dense compared to the air around us.
Below the compressed atmosphere is a crust of ionized iron, a mixture of crystal iron nuclei and free-flowing iron electrons.
Now, the gravity is so strong that it's almost perfectly smooth. The biggest mountains on the surface are going to be less than a quarter of an inch high.
A quarter-inch mountain range may sound odd. But things get even stranger as we go below the surface. This is home to the strongest material in the universe. It's so weird. Scientists liken it to nuclear pasta.
As we dive beneath the crust of a neutron star, the neutrons themselves start to glue themselves together into exotic shapes. First, they form clumps that look something like gnocchi. Then deeper, the gnocchi glue themselves together to form long strands that look like spaghetti. Even deeper, the spaghetti fuse together to form sheets of lasagna. And then finally, the lasagna fuse together to become a uniform mass, but with holes in it, so it looks like penne.
This is pasta, nuclear style, simmering at a temperature of over 1,000,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Extreme gravity bends, squeezes, stretches, and buckles neutrons, creating a material 100,000 billion times denser than iron. But the journey gets even more extreme.
Even deeper is more mysterious and harder to understand. The core of a neutron star, which is very far away from these layers, which we call the nuclear pasta, is perhaps the most exotic form of matter. So exotic, it might be the last bastion of matter before complete gravitational collapse into a black hole.
Data from NASA's Chandra Observatory suggests the core is made up of a superfluid, a bizarre, friction-free state of matter. Superfluids produced in the lab exhibit strange properties, such as the ability to flow upwards and escape airtight containers. Although our knowledge of the star's interior is still hazy, there's no mystery about its dazzling birth. Forged into life during the most spectacular event the universe has to offer, the explosive death of a massive star.
Neutron stars spark into life amid the death of their parent star. They are the ultimate story of resurrection or of life from death.
It's all part of a cosmic cycle.
Stars are born from giant clouds of very cold gas. Those clouds collapse under their own gravity, and the density of the core at the center of that collapse starts to increase.
A star is a huge nuclear fusion reactor. The force of its gravity is so powerful that it fuses atoms together to make progressively heavier and heavier elements.
The star fuses hydrogen into helium. Once it exhausts its hydrogen, then if it's massive enough, it can start fusing helium at its core.
Fusion continues forming carbon, oxygen, nitrogen, all the way up to iron.
Once a star has iron in the core, it's almost like you've poisoned it, because this extinguishes the nuclear reactions in the core of the star.
You fuse something into iron and you get no energy. All of a sudden, there's nothing to support the crush of gravity.
No radiation pressure pushing out means no pressure keeping the outer regions from falling in, and that's what they do.
As the star collapses in its death throes, its core becomes the wildest, craziest, and freakiest pressure cooker in the whole universe. The ingredients are all in place. Time to start cooking up a neutron star.